Guys, welcome back to ElGods. Today we are going to discuss another interview question on arrays. So this is a tricky one. So watch the video till the end and then share your views in the comment section. So let's get going. Says that we are given a set of distinct integers, right? And we need to print the size of maximum size subset of this set such that the sum of any two numbers in the subset we choose, which is basically s dash, is not divisible by k, right? So here an example is given. So before discussing the example, let's see the case when the sum of two numbers would be divisible by k, right? So originally we have a set S which has various elements in it, distinct elements, right? And we need to filter out a subset S dash such that the elements we choose in this subset are not divisible. The sum of any two numbers is not divisible by k. K would be given to us, right? Okay. So now let's take two numbers n1 and n2, right? Now I can express n1 as k into x1 plus y1, right? And similarly I can express n2 as k into x2 plus y2, right? Where y1 is the remainder and y2 is also the remainder when n1 and n2 are divided by k, right? Okay, so now let's sum up these two numbers to generate a new number, let's say capital N, right? So this number would become k into x1 plus x2 plus y1 plus y2, right? Now let's see what value can we get in this range of y1 plus y2, right? Now we know that y1 and y2 are the remainders when these two numbers are divided by k. So y1 comma y2 would be greater than equal to 0 and less than k, right? So y1 plus y2 would be greater than equal to 0 and less than equal to twice of k minus 1, right? Since the maximum possible value is k minus 1, so if both give remainder k minus 1, then the maximum possible value is twice of k minus 1, right? So starting from 0 till twice of k minus 1. So let's see when how many numbers exist in this range which can be divisible by k. So only a single number exists, which is a number k itself, and 2k would exist after that, and that is outside our range, so we don't need to consider that. And 0 obviously, but 0 is a fishy case and we would discuss this exception in the end. So first let's see this case. So this says that y1 plus y2 is k. Only in this case the number n would become k into x1 plus x2 plus k, and then it would become divisible by k, right? So we have to choose such numbers such that the sum of their remainders is not equal to k, right? Okay. So let's see how what remainder is given by each number, like remainder 0 is given by these numbers, 1 is given by these numbers, and so on, right? So now let's take the example given above. So the example is 19 10 12. Let's note it down. So S is given to be 19 10 12, right? And then it's 10 24 25 22. So 10 24, 25 and 22, and k was given to be 4, right? So now the remainders can be starting from 0, 1, 2 and 3. And initially let's take the numbers giving remainder 0, 1, 2 and 3 to be 0, right? And now we would update it as required. So 19 divided by 4 gives a remainder of 3, so we update this counter. Now 10 divided by 4 gives a remainder of 2, so we update this counter. Now 12 divided by 4 gives a remainder of 0, so we update this counter. 10 divided by 4 again gives a remainder 2, so we update it. And 24 divided by 4 again gives 0, so we update this value. Now coming to 25, it gives a remainder of 1, so updating this. And finally 22, it also gives a remainder of 2, right? So this value becomes 3, right? Now you see that let's say I have some numbers which are generating a remainder I, and I have some numbers which are generating the remainder k minus I. So now either I can choose this whole lot or I can choose this whole lot, but I cannot choose both of them, since in this case the sum of their remainders would become k and the property which is required would not be followed, right? So either I can choose all this complete set or I can choose this complete set, right? So our answer of the maximum size comes out to be summation of I varying from 1 to k by 2 and maximum of the numbers generating a remainder I and the numbers generating a remainder k minus I, because I can either choose the whole lot generating remainder I or k minus I, but cannot choose both of them, right? So this is the equation which we have formed finally. So let's see the fishy cases now, which we were discussing earlier. So the fishy case can be the numbers which are generating a remainder of 0. So if we choose any two such numbers which are generating number 0, their sum would also generate a remainder 0 when divided by k, right? So we can choose at maximum of one number which is generating a remainder of 0, right? And the other fishy case can be when k is even, right? And then in that case I and k minus I would become same, k by 2 and k by 2, and hence it would not be covered in this case, right? So now we need to consider this as well separately, and this is almost similar to the case of 0, because if we choose any two such numbers whose remainder is k by 2 and k is even, right? So k by 2 would be an integer. So if we choose any two integers, then their sum would be divisible by k again, right? And then the property would not be followed. So from this set of k by 2, if k is even, we can only choose at max one number, right, which is generating a remainder of k by 2, right? So now our final answer, which is basically the maximum size, let's update it, right? So it is summation of I varying from 1 to k by 2, right? And always choosing the maximum size set of the numbers generating a remainder I or generating a remainder k minus I, added to at max one number which is generating a remainder of 0, and similarly at maximum one number which is generating a remainder k by 2, right? So this is the final statement which we have got, and the reason for choosing this is that only the two numbers which can give a sum divisible by k can only be those numbers which are generating a remainder y1 and y2, such that y1 and y2 sums up to k, right? And this we proved above by taking two general numbers, right? So now let's get back to our case and see what would be the answer in this case, right? So yeah, so these were the remainders and these were the count of numbers generating such remainder, right? So in this case k is even, so we need to consider the k by 2 case separately. Also we need to consider the case where remainder is 0 separately. So first let's take these two cases. So we have two numbers which are generating a remainder of 0, right? So we can at max choose one number. Now coming on to k by 2, k is 4, so k by 2 becomes 2. So there are three numbers which are generating a remainder of two, right? So we can at max choose one number, right? And now these cases are covered. So let's go to 1 and k minus 1. So 1 and k is 4. So it becomes 3, right? So number generating a remainder 1 is 1, and number generating remainder 3 is also 1. So we can choose either of them, and that would be 1 because both are equal. So this sums up to 3, and you notice then there is no use of going further, since after this point it would become 2, which is k by 2, right? And we need it to go till k by 2 only. So these are the three numbers which we can choose, and this is the maximum size of the subset which we can choose from this set, such that sum of any two numbers existing in this subset is not divisible by k, which is given out to be 4, right? So let's verify our answer. So yeah, you see there are two subsets possible. One is 10, 12, 25. This also has a size of 3, and other is 19, 22, and 24. This also has a size 3. So you see 10 plus 12 is 22, which is not divisible by 4. Similarly, you can take any two numbers in these and they would not be divisible by 4, right? So the maximum size of the subset in this case is 3. So this is the approach which we followed for getting this answer. We first found out what would be the case when the numbers, sum of numbers would be divisible by k. And for that, we found out the condition that their remainders individually should sum up to k, right? So using this property, we generated the remainders and their respective counts. And then using this property again, we formulated this formula, added the exceptional cases, which are 0 and k by 2, and finally got our answer to be 3, right? So now let us discuss the time and the space complexity. So for iterating, for generating this, basically the remainder count, we need to iterate through all the numbers. So that loop would take in order of n, right? So the time complexity of this approach is in order of n. And now let's see to the space complexity. So we need an array to store this count from 0 to k minus 1, right? So we need an array of size k to store this. So the space complexity would be in order of k, right? So this is the time complexity and space complexity for this approach. I hope you would have understood the approach clearly. Still, if you have any doubts, you can comment in the comment section. And for your further queries, you can join our Telegram group. The link is given in the description below. Thank you.